Hi, this is Pat with Pat's Two Cents with God's Church of Love Online every Saturday and Tuesday. And Jeanette is getting ready to share a word that God laid on her heart for our church.
The Lord gave me a small, just a small word, but very powerful. Mm-hmm. And it relates to what happened to Rashawn in regards to the love that was shown to him when he left his job.
Right.
Because of the light that is in him and the gesture of the supervisor buying him a card and people going to him saying they're going to miss him because of the light and the love that he's shown that came through him that he didn't realize. The small things become great when done with love. A kindness, a word of encouragement, telling somebody to believe, have faith. Just any small things become great when done with love.
Yep,
that's
right.
And this is what we need to share in the times that we're living in, because people around us are hurting. They're terrified. The devil's trying to put hate in people, and we got to let love flow, because it's power in love, protection.
Yes.
In love. The demons can't touch you. The virus can't come near you when you walk in love. Mm-hmm. And when that love flows through you, it comes through your body. I really believe that when the woman that had the issue of blood touched the garment, she just touched the hem of his garment.
That's right.
And the power flew through Jesus' clothes, because the clothes was on his body. And his body was the word. And his body was love. And we have that in us now, because we have Jesus in us. And now we got to rise up and walk in that power to Jesus while he was humble.
Right.
And powerful.
Right.
All humble. While walking ball of love. That love had power in it. Mm-hmm. It had protection in it. Truth in it. Strength in it. And we need to walk in it like Rashawn. He walked in it. He walks in it. And that's why that happened to him. And you continue to walk in that love and let your light shine. Don't be ashamed of Christ. Don't be ashamed. Because in the time that we're in now, we're going to be persecuted. Everybody's not going to receive. That's okay. Keep on walking in his power and his love.
Right.
That seed has been planted. And they will know. Because things are going to get deep, people. Pray, because November's coming. Things are going to get more intense. And we got to walk in that love. And this is like I shared with you, John 14, verse 21. The person who has my commandments and keeps them is the one who really loves me.
Mm-hmm.
And whoever really loves me will be loved by my Father. And I, too, will love him and will show and reveal myself to him. I will let myself be clearly seen by him and make myself with him. That's powerful. He's going to make himself real to you personally. You got to get that person. I want him to come to me. Come to me, Jesus, and make yourself real to me in this time and season that I'm in, that we're all in.
That's right.
I need you to be more real than the breath I take.
Mm-hmm.
And then Judas Iscariot asked him, Lord, how is it that you will reveal yourself, make yourself real to us and not to the world? And Jesus answered, if a person really loves me, he will keep my word and obey my teaching. And my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home, abide, special dwelling place with him. That's powerful.
It is.
Grasp that. Jesus and the Father are going to come to you. You. Not Ed, not anybody else. You. And make themselves real to us, real to you. That's a personal, I want you to be real to me.
Right.
Personally like that. And that real, that love, it'll overtake you.
When
people are talking about you, looking at you crazy, judging you, keep on walking in that love, baby. Because it's more powerful than all that noise.
Right.
Stop looking at the noise around, because noise is going to increase. It's going to increase. Let your light and your love increase more. And your light and your love will burn that noise up around you.
That's right.
It'll shut it up. It'll burn it up.
Shut it down.
You walking in that power. You walking in that power of love. Love is all powerful. And no demon in hell can stand against it. No devil in hell can stand against it.
That's right.
And he gives us the power to forgive. Love is so powerful. I think about those people in the church that when those African Americans in the church were killed by the young man, and that the people of the church, they forgave him.
Right.
Love him. Love is so powerful.
Yes, it is.
It gives you the strength to do the supernatural.
Yes.
Hey, that's straight up from God right there.
Yep.
Love is so powerful. It gives you the strength to do the supernatural.
That's right.
That's what we're going to need in these times to win. We're in the last days. This is it. The clock is ticking.
Yep.
Whether you want to believe it or not, the clock is ticking.
Mm-hmm.
And love is going to give us the power to live in the supernatural, because we're going to have to live in the supernatural. What's going to come on this earth, what's already on and coming. We're going to have to live and walk in that love and the power of that love to survive. And he'll provide.
That's right.
And he'll take care of our needs. He'll make sure we have shelter. What did he say? Psalm 23? No, I got to go there. Psalm 23. What did he say? The Lord is my shepherd. To feed, guide, and shield me. I should not lack. So, there it is.
Amen.
That's it.
Amen.
So do our part. Walk in the power of the love of Christ. And let that love flow through your body to where it's on your clothes. Think supernaturally. Don't think like the world thinks. Our thoughts have to be like God's thoughts. Our thoughts have to be higher than the fleshy, worldly thoughts.
That's right.
Petty,
that's
stupid,
right.
Full of envy, jealousy. Who's competing with who? No. It's not about no competition, about nothing. We are the light in a dark world. The world is getting darker. Our light has to shine brighter so we can win as many souls and bring them into the kingdom before this thing is over.
Right. Right. Thank you so much, Jeanette. I appreciate that word. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Jesus.
Yes.
We praise him.
The soul
magnify him.
Yes.
Woo, he's on the throne. He's up there and all that glory and beauty.
The song that came to my mind when Jeanette was bringing that word of exhortation is Ordinary People. I'm going to sing a real quick short thing of it. Then I'm going to come right in with the word followed by Lynette. Just ordinary people. God uses ordinary people. He uses people just like you and me who are willing to do as he commands. He uses people who are willing to give him their all. No matter how small their all might seem to you, your little becomes much when you place it in the Master's hand. God bless you.